In the last round, when I hit him with the left hand, I was right handed and I switched to southpaw. And when I hit him with the left hook, I saw him got touched. So I said, all right, he might have broken for the other punch. And that's when I caught him. And that's when he fell.
Were you frustrated about his head movement? He was doing a lot of bobbing and weaving, and you missed him slightly in a couple of early rounds. How did you not get frustrated with just his overall head movement and body movement?
I mean, anybody will get frustrated, you know, but it is part of the game, like they say, right? So I was a little, you know, annoyed by it, but other than that, I was just staying focused and sticking to the plan. And I would box him out, and not gonna come, I come.
Were you surprised he was able to stand for 7 rounds? Because I saw you were tagging with uppercuts, right hooks, and he's just literally there like a bobby, you know, like a dummy.
Oh, ball. That guy, man, he holds all them punches. I'll tell you one thing, he was one tough. I think he must have been like the toughest fighter I ever had, to tell you the truth. So he was really tough. I can say that he really was.
Last time I saw you at the Pascal press conference,
yeah.
You were with Floyd Sr.
Mm-hmm.
What connections do you have, and what did you learn from him, and what did you bring from that into this fight?
Mayweather Senior is a legend. So yeah, he told me one the bobby move, you know.
Yeah.
He told me that.
I saw you bring that into the ring there.
Yeah.
I saw you apply a little bit of it.
It was something good. I like that. You know, you mentioned it. It looked good.
Yeah, it looked good.
Boom, boom. So yeah, I'll try it out. He told me that.
Keith, that was your 10th knockout. Was that your best knockout in your career yet? The most impressive one?
So right now, I believe it was. Yes, it was.
What's next? Who would you want next? You can call three people out.
Honestly, I'm not like that. I just want to say, give me whoever you want to give me, and I'll be ready for you. And I'll take care of business. That's why it's about the best. I love fighting.
Where do you stand with the weight? You're eating today at 200 pounds. Do you want to stay at cruiserweight? Do you want to go heavyweight?
Well, for now, I'm staying at cruiserweight for now. I'm trying to get the belt for cruiserweight. Then after that, I'm going to jump on to heavyweight. But eventually, I will be a heavyweight. Eventually.
What's your thoughts on the recent sign, or alleged signing right now, Marco Hoop to Al Haymon? Does that help you help motivate you now that you know that Marco Hoop, probably the biggest name in the cruiserweight division, it's a fight that could be made easier now for you?
I want to shout out to Al Haymon, because I appreciate that he happy with him. And Marco Hoop, bring him down. I would love to fight him, tell you the truth. No disrespect, it's just that when I'm in shape, I feel like nobody can beat him. And I feel like I am the greatest, because God is good.
How'd it feel to be out here with all your Boricuas, man, out here in New York repping the BX? You're out here doing your thing, big time, Spike, PBC. How does that feel for you right now, you know, being an up-and-coming fighter?
That motivated me even more, you know. My people were here, my mother, my brother, you know. It was something big for me. I was really, just really happy, real, real happy.
Where in the Bronx are you from?
I'm from the South Bronx. I'm by the 2 train, by the 2 and 6 train.
Did you feel yourself kind of wearing him down, kind of?
Actually, no.
No,
actually, no. He was tough. He was really tough. I never denied nothing. The guy hit me good. He hit me good. No, he beat me. He beat me. I can say about that guy, he was tough. He hit all my punches.
What do you feel you need to improve on going forward? I mean, this is a nice win, but what do you feel you need to do to start to win against guys who are top 25, top 15?
This right here, I got to build my body up more. I have to build my body up. Other than that, I got all the skills in the world. Thank God.
Last question before I let you go. So you're now Floyd Mayweather Senior. Who else is part of Team Tapping? Who else will be brought in to sort of help you mold into the next level?
I do Flex Sandwich, my trainer. And Jack Stanton, that been with me since I was 11. You know, and my family, of course, you know? Other than that, oh yeah, don't forget God. Without him,
there you have it. There you go. Once again, we got Victoria Sears, Keith Abbott. Keith, where do the fans check you out? Where's the Twitter page, website, Facebook, Instagram?
Facebook, that's all I have. My real name, Keep Tapia. Facebook, check me out. Oh yeah, and I have a fan page too, Keep Tapia.
Very good. Once again, we got Keep Tapia. Keith, always an honor, pleasure having you on the show.
Robin?
Always an honor, pleasure having you on the show.
Thank you very much, and I appreciate you having
me. Anytime, we get back to a whole lot more, only on Last Call. Last Call with the Alcohol, CyberStationUSA.com.
So there you have it, another great video for ES News. For ESNewsReporting.com, I'm Ellie Secback reporting, and you can follow me on Twitter @Secback, and you can follow me on Instagram @EllieSecback.